Hey all, welcome to Share Trek. This is Raj here. Friends, we have some blockbuster news today, and it's going to be about Gilead Sciences. You guys know Gilead already. It's a huge company which has made a lot of HIV therapies, and they have announced fantastic results from their phase 2 for Lenacapavir. Approval seems imminent to me by 2025 based on what I see. I want to talk more about it and give you details. Let's get started. Welcome back, friends. Gilead Sciences announced that its experimental drug Lenacapavir was 100% effective in preventing HIV among women in late-stage trial. And this is a significant breakthrough as it demonstrated that none of the 2,000 women who received the twice-yearly shot contracted HIV. This result led to the recommendation to their unblinding the trial and to offer Lenacapavir to all the participants, underscoring the drug's potential as highly effective form of pre-exposure prophylaxis or PrEP. And the current HIV prevention landscape, as you know, relies heavily on daily pills, which we call as ART. These are pills which include Gilead's own Truvada and Descovy. While these medications are effective, adherence to daily regimens can be challenging for many, especially professionals who are traveling from place to place, and many others might benefit from not having to take tablets daily, but instead once in a 6 months. Lenacapavir fits that niche very clearly. Lenacapavir, with its twice yearly injection schedule, offers a more convenient option, which could improve adherence and expand the reach of PrEP. Now, coming to the topic of broad efficacy of existing PrEP. Existing PrEP has been proven to reduce the risk of acquiring HIV from sex by 99% and from injected drug use by around 74% when taken correctly. Despite this, uptake remains low, with only about 1/3 of eligible individuals in the US using PrEP. The introduction of Lenacapavir could address this gap by providing an easier, less frequent dosing option, potentially increasing PrEP adoption rates and therefore reducing the spread rates. New patients might be less. And approximately, I would say that in 2022, approximately there were 1 million new HIV infections that occurred globally. Longer acting PrEP options like Lenacapavir could be crucial in reducing these numbers, particularly in areas with high infection rates and low adherence to daily medications. By offering twice yearly injections, healthcare providers can ensure consistent protection without relying on patients to remember daily doses. Healthcare perspective for people living with HIV is also quite significant in light of the new data from Lenacapavir. Improved adherence to treatment regimen is critical for viral suppression and preventing progression of the disease. Lenacapavir's long-acting formulations could also be adopted for treatment, not just prevention, offering a new option for patients who struggle with daily pill regimens. This could lead to better health outcomes and quality of life for people living with HIV. Now, we have to see how the medical community decides to deploy Lenacapavir. Is it purely as a PrEP or if it could have other uses? But I'm just speculating out here. So don't quote me on that. I'm just being optimistic. Then the other aspect is the stigma associated with HIV can deter individuals from taking daily pills due to the fear of being discovered. And an injectionable option administered twice a year reduces the frequency of medication intake, which can help maintain privacy and reduce the stigma. This can encourage more individuals to seek and adhere to treatment and prevention measures. And at this point of time, Lenacapavir is in phase 2. Before Lenacapavir can be approved by the FDA, Gilead needs to replicate the trial results in a similar study involving men who have sex with men. If these results are positive, Lenacapavir could become available by late 2025, somewhere around the last quarter of 2025 or early 2026. And the successful completion of these studies will be crucial for regulatory approval and market introduction. And while Lenacapavir shows promise, its success will also depend on its accessibility and affordability, particularly in low and middle income countries. Gilead has faced criticism in the past over the pricing of its HIV medications, with current PrEP options like Descovy costing around $26,000 annually in the US, which is a big amount of money. And activists are urging the company to ensure Lenacapavir is affordable and accessible to those in high incidence areas. This will be essential for maximizing the drug's global impact. And I think from a government and public health administration perspective, a therapy that is once in every 6 months should be worthwhile pursuing, because then compliance becomes much more easier. And I'm hoping that it has an uptake in the government support as well, in terms of providing it for free. We'll have to see how it pans out. We wait for more information. Health policymakers and advocates emphasize the need for diverse PrEP options to cater to different lifestyles and preferences. And Lenacapavir's long-acting nature aligns with these potential goals, potentially increasing the overall effectiveness of HIV prevention strategies and adding one more tools to the prevention arsenal. Analysts project that Lenacapavir could generate significant interest and revenue and estimated peak sales of nearly $2 billion. And this financial success could further incentivize the development of long-acting HIV prevention and treatment options, contributing to broader public health benefits. But then if you look at it purely from the perspective of people living with HIV, the question they have is, okay, this is good for prevention. So for those who are not already infected, they can protect themselves. What about people who are already with HIV? So I'm studying a little more on that angle, and if I get more information, I'll make one more video and present it to you specifically with regard to Lenacapavir. In conclusion, I'll say that Gilead's Lenacapavir presents a promising advancement in HIV prevention, offering a highly effective long-acting PrEP option that could significantly impact global HIV prevention efforts. Its success could lead to improved adherence, reduced stigma, and enhanced prevention strategies. However, addressing accessibility and affordability will be crucial to ensuring its widespread impact, particularly in high-incidence regions. And the ongoing trials and subsequent FDA approval process will be key milestones in bringing this innovative solution to the market and transforming the HIV prevention and care landscape. So friends, so that was the good news that I wanted to provide you. With that, I would like to end this video here, and I'll catch up with you again in the next video, probably next week. Have a great weekend, and help the channel grow. You can see we are growing fast. Our subscriber numbers are growing. Push us on to 15,000. Please press the subscribe button, send it to your friends so that they can become subscribers. And it'll be really good for you to become a member if you're a non-English speaking person. Especially Hindi people can join the members section, so that you can see the Zoom meeting that we have where I translate things into Hindi. With that, my friends, I'd like to bring this video to an end. Thanks and have a great day. Bye for now.